Good morning, church. Great to see you all. Thank you for joining us for worship at St. Mary's Episcopal Church in Portsmouth, Rhode Island. Whether you're here on the lawn or in your car, or if you're joining us online, thank you for being a part of our worship. Today is a special day here at St. Mary's. We are celebrating the baptism of Hudson Russell Palakiko, a grandchild of Stacy and Steve Downing. So very special day, our first baptism since last January. So we're thrilled to be able to celebrate with Hudson's family. Part of our worship will also be Holy Communion. Please know that all Christians are welcome to receive Holy Communion today, which is a part of our worship. We do have a couple of safety procedures to follow. So first of all, you've all found your way to your place. Please know that at the end of the service, we would like you to exit through the yellow cones. And if you're driving out, please know that you need to drive out through the back of our property as you leave. Drive through the back. That just keeps everybody safe. When it is time for Holy Communion, a greeter will, if you're on the lawn, a greeter will welcome you forward. As you come forward, we're going to maintain a distance. Please extend your arms out as far as they'll go. I will extend mine, make a cup out of your hands, and I will drop the blessed sacrament into your hands. If you're in the reserve section or in your car, communion will be brought out to you. In other announcements, as we look toward the end of the month, we are going to have we're calling it a trick-or-treat parade, trick-or-treat drive-through. So if you would like to help with this offering, it's for all of the St. Mary's children and families and also for the wider community. We're going to set up a socially distanced, safe trick-or-treat experience from 4 to 5 on Halloween. That's Saturday the 31st. So if you would like to create a parking space where you can safely hand out candy, you'll get lots of instructions, but please see Marlo or email her. Otherwise, I think those are the announcements. Read the rest online on our webpage or in our e-news. If you are our guest today, please know how grateful we are that you have come to join us, and especially if you're a part of Hudson's family. We're so glad to be together on this beautiful day. So we're going to have a moment of silence now as we prepare ourselves for worship.
and grief. Fill me, radiancy divine, scatter all my unbelief. More and more thyself display, shining to the perfect day.
Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, and blessed be his kingdom, now and forever. Amen. There is one body and one spirit. There is one hope in God's call to us, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest. Let us sing glory to God today. We come to worship the Lord. Everyone here and around the world, listen and heed our God's word. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest. All of the creatures above, below, flowers and trees, sun and rain. God has done wonderful things for us. We will sing praises again. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest. Glory to God in the highest. All of the angels did sing. God is his son to deliver us, Jesus our heavenly King. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest.
God be with you. Let us pray. Lord, we pray that your grace may always precede and follow us, that we may continually be given to good works through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
A reading from Isaiah. O Lord, you are my God. I will exalt you. I will praise your name. For you have done wonderful things, plans formed of old, faithful and sure. For you have made the city a heap, the fortified city a ruin. The palace of aliens is a city no more. It will never be rebuilt. Therefore, strong peoples will glorify you. Cities of ruthless nations will fear you. For you have been a refuge to the poor, a refuge to the needy in their distress, a shelter from the rainstorm, and a shade from the heat. When the blast of the ruthless was like a winter rainstorm, the noise of aliens like heat in a dry place, you subdued the heat with the shade of clouds. The song of the ruthless was stilled. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will make for all peoples a feast of rich food, a feast of well-aged wines, of rich food filled with marrow, of well-aged wines strained clear. And he will destroy on this mountain the shroud that is cast over all peoples, the sheet that is spread over all nations. He will swallow up death forever. Then the Lord God will wipe away the tears from all faces. and the disgrace of his people he will take away from all the earth. For the Lord has spoken. It will be said on that day, lo, this is our God, and we have waited for him so that he might save us. This is the Lord for whom we have waited. Let us be glad and rejoice in his salvation. The word of the Lord. Second reading is a reading from Philippians. My brothers and sisters, whom I love and long for, my joy and crown, stand firm in the Lord in this way, my beloved. I urge Euodia and Syntyche to be of the same mind of the Lord. Yes, and I ask you also, my loyal companion, help these women, for they have struggled beside me in the work of the gospel. Together with Clement and the rest of my co-workers, whose names are in the book of life. Rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I will say, rejoice. Let your gentleness be known to everyone. The Lord is near. Do not worry about anything, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Finally, beloved, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is pleasing, whatever is commendable, if there is any excellence, and if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things. Keep on doing the things that you have learned and received and heard and seen in me, and the God of peace will be with you. The word of the Lord.
The Holy Gospel of our Savior Jesus Christ according to Matthew. Glory to you, Lord Christ. Jesus spoke to them in parables, saying, "The kingdom of heaven may be compared to a king who gave a wedding banquet for his son. He sent his slaves to call those who had been invited to the wedding banquet, but they would not come. Again, he sent other slaves, saying, 'Tell those who have been invited, look, I have prepared my dinner, my oxen and my fat calves have been slaughtered, and everything is ready. Come to the wedding banquet.' But they made light of it and went away, one to his farm, another to his business, while the rest seized his slaves, mistreated them, and killed them. The king was enraged. He sent his troops, destroyed those murderers, and burned their city. Then he said to his slaves, 'The wedding is ready, but those invited were not worthy. Go therefore into the main streets and invite everyone you find to the wedding banquet.' Those slaves went out into the streets and gathered all whom they found, both good and bad. So the wedding hall was filled with guests. But when the king came in to see the guests, he noticed a man there who was not wearing a wedding robe, and he said to him, 'Friend, how did you get in here without a wedding robe?' And he was speechless. Then the king said to the attendants, 'Bind him hand and foot and throw him into the outer darkness. where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. For many are called, but few are chosen. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Christ. I wish to speak to you in the name of God, who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. I wonder, when was the last time you were invited to a great feast? For most of us, 2020 has not been a year of extravagant celebration. Sure, there have been the usual milestones, but we humans have had to find creative ways to celebrate. Will we ever forget the virtual graduations, the drive-through birthday parades, or the online bridal showers? Invitations to in-person gatherings, either publicly or privately, have been rare. And cancellations have been common. This week, as the leaves are changing, we may have begun to look toward the holiday season, thinking about what the fall and winter holidays will be like. We know that this year, invitations will not be flooding our inboxes or our mailboxes. For now, our feasting will remain somewhat restrained. Here at church, we notice this. We notice that our table fellowship has changed. We are still dearly missing our coffee hours, our dinner meetings, the potluck suppers, and just regular gatherings to share a meal. Like so many other things this year, other changes, our feasting has been paused, or at least toned down, and this is not easy for us. As humans, we're created for connection and relationship, and so much of this happens as we share meals. Food is how we connect. Table fellowship is essential for our well-being. It's how we show love and affection. The same is true in our relationship with God. The table is surely a place where God's love and connection are made known. This morning, our scriptures offer several images of God's abundant feasts. The food, the company, the invitations. They're all extravagant. From the prophet Isaiah, we have an image of a lavish banquet, one on the mountain, where there will be a table spread before those who are in great distress. It's a table laid with rich food, food filled with marrow. And there is wine, well-aged wine strained clear. This abundance is a sign offering hope to those who have suffered greatly. This invitation, this vision, is also extravagant in terms of the guest list. The Lord of hosts will create this feast for all people. This feast will be healing, destroying the shroud that is cast over all peoples, all nations. No one will be left out. At this feast, the Lord God will wipe away the tears from all faces. Not only will God's food and wine nourish those who suffer, but God's feast will be shared universally. No one will be left behind when it comes to God's salvation. We heard the familiar 23rd Psalm today sung, and in it there's another image. It's the image of the table. The psalmist says, "You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows." This is a tender, vulnerable image. One in which table companionship is not with a close, intimate friend, but rather the table is set in the presence of enemies. The tension is eased somehow at the Lord's table. There is healing in this feast. There is the relief of the soothing oil wiped on a forehead and a plenteous drink to quench the thirst. And then, of course, we have that gospel today, the parable of the wedding banquet, which I must admit holds too many images that are not altogether healing. Just want to say, for the record, you can wear whatever you want to church without being thrown into the outer darkness. Today, what might be most useful for us in this gospel is to simply focus on the idea of the boundless invitation. The king wants more than anything to invite his people to the feast, and he has prepared a lavish wedding banquet, absolutely relentless in trying to fill the hall. So when the first invitations are rejected, he decides to invite absolutely everyone, without exception. He sends his slaves out to the streets to gather whosoever they can find. He wants the good. He wants the bad. He wants everyone there. There is no one who does not receive an invitation, and the hall is filled. The capacity seems infinite. These images in Scripture point toward God's invitation to come to the table. Come to the table where our deepest needs are satisfied, where relationships are reconciled, where our faith is strengthened. We are constantly and consistently being invited to share in God's abundant feast, though we don't always respond. Sometimes we don't show up. Doesn't matter to God. He invites us again and again and again. All of us, relentlessly. Often this invitation is to a real table, a meal with people whose very presence reminds us of God's abundance. Sometimes the invitation is to come to worship, to share in the Feast of Holy Communion, or to hear God's word as our food. Sometimes the invitation is to participate in the feeding of others, sharing what we have with neighbors who need us to share. And sometimes the invitation is simply to sit in silence and listen for God's voice. This morning, we've all accepted the invitation to be here to celebrate in the baptism of Hudson Russell Palakiko. We celebrate with Hudson's family as we welcome him into the household of God. Every baptism is an opportunity for us to remember how persistent God is in offering invitation. remembering our baptism and renewing our own covenant, is an acceptance of our place at the table, an invitation that stands through all eternity. In just a moment, Hudson's parents and godparents will renounce the forces which cause us to reject God's invitation to abundant life. And then they will affirm a new life in Jesus Christ, promising to follow and obey Jesus as their Lord. And after this, we will all promise to do what we can to support Hudson in his new life. And that is an invitation in itself. Remember that what we do together as the church is to offer support and encouragement to one another. Our place in the church is by God's invitation, but there's something for each of us to do here. We are, each and every one of us, invited and called to give as well as to receive. After we offer our support to Hudson, we are going to renew our own covenant, remembering our own promises. Promises we can only keep with God's help. And then we will witness the water poured over this small boy's head, signifying his new birth. We will see, and some of us will even smell, the oil smeared on his forehead. May it remind us that there is nothing we can do and nothing that can be done to us that will ever separate us from the love of God in Jesus Christ. We will always be on God's guest list. God will continue to call us to the table along with everyone else, including our enemies. And there we will feast today, tomorrow, and for all eternity. Thanks be to God. As our celebration continues, let us gather at the font, the waters of new life. The candidate for holy baptism will now be presented. Let's try one more time.
I present Hudson Russell to receive the sacrament of baptism.
Will you be responsible for seeing that the child you present is brought up in the Christian faith and life?
I will, God, no.
Will you, by your prayers and witness, help this child to grow into the full stature of Christ? Do you renounce Satan and all the spiritual forces of wickedness that rebel against God?
I renounce them.
Do you renounce the evil powers of this world, which corrupt and destroy the creatures of God?
I renounce them.
Do you renounce all sinful desires that draw you from the love of God? Do you turn to Jesus Christ and accept him as your Savior? Do you put your whole trust in His grace and love?
I do.
Do you promise to follow and obey Him as your Lord?
I do.
This next question is for the whole congregation. Will you who witness these vows do all in your power to support this person in his life in Christ?
We will.
Let us join with him who's committing himself to Christ and renew our own baptismal promises. Do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God the Father.
Creator of heaven and earth. Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God? I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. Do you believe in God the Holy Spirit? I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Will you continue in the apostles' teaching and fellowship, in the breaking of bread, and in the prayers?
I will, God's help.
Will you persevere in resisting evil, and whenever you fall into sin, repent and return to the Lord?
I will, God's help.
Will you proclaim by word and example the good news of God in Christ?
I will.
Will you seek and serve Christ in all persons, loving your neighbor as yourself?
I will, God's help.
Will you strive for justice and peace among all people, and respect the dignity of every human being? I will, with God's help. Let us now pray for this person who is to receive the sacrament of new birth.
Deliver him, O Lord, from the way of sin and death.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Open his heart to your grace and truth.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Fill him with your holy and life-giving spirit.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Keep him in the faith and communion of your holy church.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Teach him to love others in the power of the Spirit.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Send him into the world in witness to your love.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Bring him to the fullness of your peace and glory.
Lord, hear our prayer. Grant, O Lord, that all who are baptized into the death of Jesus Christ, your Son, may live in the power of his resurrection, and look for him to come again in glory, who lives and reigns now and forever. Amen. Keep going. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give him thanks and praise.
We thank you, Almighty God, for the gift of water. Over it, the Holy Spirit moved in the beginning of creation. Through it, you led the children of Israel out of their bondage in Egypt into the land of promise. in it your son Jesus received the baptism of John and was anointed by the Holy Spirit as the Messiah, the Christ, to lead us through his death and resurrection from the bondage of sin into everlasting life. We thank you, Father, for the water of baptism. In it we are buried with Christ in his death. By it we share in his resurrection. Through it we are reborn by the Holy Spirit. Therefore, in joyful obedience to your Son, we bring into his fellowship those who come to him in faith, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Now, sanctify this water, we pray you, by the power of your Holy Spirit, that those who hear are cleansed from sin and born again, may continue forever in the risen life of Jesus Christ, your Savior. To him, to you, and to the Holy Spirit, be all honor and glory, now and forever. Amen. Amen. Name this child. Hudson Russell, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you that by water and the Holy Spirit you have bestowed upon this your servant the forgiveness of sin and have raised him to the new life of grace. Sustain him, O Lord, in your Holy Spirit. Give him an inquiring and discerning heart, the courage to will and to persevere, a spirit to know and to love you, and the gift of joy and wonder in all your works. Amen. Hudson Russell, you are sealed by the Holy Spirit in baptism and marked as Christ's own forever. Amen. And now let us all welcome the newly baptized. We receive you into the household of God. Confess the faith of Christ crucified, proclaim his resurrection, and share with us in his eternal priesthood. Receive the light of Christ and bear it forth into the world. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Please greet one another with a sign of God's peace. Okay. Thank you. Walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us in offering and sacrifice to God. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who on the first day of the week overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Give thanks to you, O God, for the goodness and love which you have made known to us in creation, in the calling of Israel to be your people, in your word spoken through the prophets, and above all, in the word made flesh, Jesus, your Son. For in these last days you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him you have delivered us from evil and made us worthy to stand before you. In him you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. On the night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, according to his command, O Father, we remember his death, we proclaim his resurrection, we await his coming in glory, and we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable through him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, put all things in subjection under your Christ, and bring us to that heavenly country where with the blessed Saint Mary and all your saints, we may enter the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation. By him and with him and in him, In the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Gifts of God for the people of God. Take them in remembrance that Christ died for you and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving.
By your body and blood, by your life and your love, renew us. May your sacrifice be forgiveness in me. Heal us. We come. to you.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart through Christ our Lord. Amen. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.
My ransomed soul.